We may be live, by the way.
Oh, Nick said I fixed Restream. You're all set.
Oh, I don't know. Okay. It's, well, it good? says it's going out live now.
Yeah, we look good.
Are we on?
I see us.
Yes, I see us on YouTube.
We did it. I'm proud of us.
Chat acknowledges. Yes. Hello, we won Crazy for Life. Lovely to see you as always.
I feel like that's like proof of life is E1 Craze for Life.
It gives $5 and says, how long do you think it'll be before the final Final Fantasy game gets released? Thanks for paying $5 to make the obvious fucking joke. E1 Crazy for Life.
I mean, do you think this franchise will ever end? I assume not.
No, I guess it's in one of those like situations where it could always come back.
Is it like Star Wars? Like, is it tenured? It's like a tenured video game series. Emeritus. Okay, yes.
Yeah. Anyway, welcome to the post-CP stream, everyone. We're playing Final Fantasy 16.
Yay!
Play, with my capture card, so excuse me while I switch the TV over. I'm joined by Marty Slaver.
Hello, everyone. And, I enjoy Final Fantasy.
And also by Toffee in the background there.
Hello, Toffee.
Who is currently giving his own personal review on the characterization in Final Fantasy 16.
Oh no. Is that Toffee or is that Torgel? Huh? That's the name of the dog in the video game.
Torgel's a bit bigger.
Torgel anyway. Is a bit. Well, not at the beginning. Torgel at the beginning is small, and then Torgel becomes very big.
Hang on, I'm just double check something. Yes. So, this is a game you seem to like. I have to say, left me a bit cold. Maybe I'm still embittered from Game of Thrones Season 8.
yeah, I think. Well, you're someone who you enjoy when the story of a game is told in conjunction, in marriage with the gameplay, with the strengths of the medium.
I'm glad you brought that up, because I'm picking a new game at this point, and the game's asking me if I want to play story-focused or action-focused. And my question to you is, where's the in-betweeny option, A?
It does feel like you should, like this, if we're going by Goldilocks and the Three Bears rule, there should be the porridge that is just right.
Well, quite, because as I said in my review, I like a blend of story and action, because that's the strength of video games and interactive narrative. I guess we'll go story focus. I guess we'll go baby game journalist mode, so I don't have to focus on it too much.
When you're playing to an audience and when you're spoofing and goofing, I think that's the easy way to go.
Go game, go!
We have a bunch of early access members. Welcome Nettobin, welcome Kanoa, Joseph, Tyler Edge, Stuart Tracht, with a little check mark by his name. That's very fancy. And Carl Johan. Welcome, guys. Thank you so much for joining early access.
Who's got a check mark?
It was Stuart Tracht.
What does that mean?
I believe it's like a verified YouTube channel.
Yeah, I suspected it's something like that.
It's like the equivalent of being like pre-Twitter bullshit verification. This is right. Like you are, I believe, a content creator of some sorts.
They must have a pretty big channel.
And you know what? I believe in them, and thank you so much for supporting us. We appreciate
Good-o.
It.
Thanks a lot. Whatever your name
have
is.
Have you ever seen the film The Lord of the Rings: The Two Towers? Because I feel like the creators of this game did when they created this scene right here.
Really?
I think they did.
Yes, I have seen Lord of the Rings: Two Towers. Well, they certainly haven't taken much influence from Final Fantasy games.
Hey, there's summons. These are characters. We know. I've been replaying Final Fantasy 1.
Oh, blimey. Which specific port of Final Fantasy 1 are we talking about here?
The recent Pixel remasters. I bought 1 through 6 on Switch, and I'm just going to kind of, as like background noise, as a second screen thing when I'm watching my programs, when I'm doing my Nolan rewatch.
I played all these shit on PC emulators, as God intended.
I've never
ROMs
played Final
that
Fantasy
you can
2 or 3.
Download for like 50 kilobytes.
They were so small. They were shockingly small. Cade Brockhausen with File Ardono. Thank you so much, Cade. Yachts, you mentioned you prefer Yahtzee to your legal name. Why not get it changed? I got mine changed, and it's the best decision of my life.
It just gets you too many funny looks when you're doing like official business. You go to the doctor's office. There's so many times I can stand a nurse having a weird expression on their face as they read out your name.
I feel like it should be illegal for someone to be weirded out by someone's legal name. I don't know how that would be judged illegal. But
well, probably not so much these days.
And be
for
smart
record,
with the
my kids all have normal names.
Who knows, though? Maybe when they reach a certain age and become prolific creators on the internet, they'll adopt a pseudonym.
Well, that's what I did.
Yeah.
Okay, let's play. Shall we play a quick rousing game of Spot the Protagonist?
Is that him?
Is it the one who's wearing completely different armor to every other character in the scene? I think it might be, yes.
Are you taking notes? You're the Realm 873.
Oh, who cares?
Did you use the active time lore at all?
For my sins, I did. Because I was, you know, everyone thinks I'm some kind of aloof person who just dismisses attempts at highfalutin storytelling. But I was genuinely trying to figure out what the fuck was going on.
There's a lot of, you get inundated with a lot of proper nouns. Very quickly.
Yeah.
A lot of people, a lot of places, a lot of events, a lot of things.
Yep.
And then Beastmarch with a $5 dono. Thank you so much, Beastmarch. Final Fantasy will end with the heat death of the universe, which will probably be pretty soon. So that's perfectly fine. And then Rass Museum. Thank you so much. Been a member for 14 months. Yats and Marty, what is your pitch for Final Fantasy 17? What would you want them to do? Go back to, like, turn-based? You want them to, like, go back to their actual roots?
I couldn't give the slightest smear of a dingleberry washed off by a morning's B-Day application.
I get taken aback every time you say bidet and say B-Day. I don't mind that you say it that way, but it just, to me, it triggers, I hear D-Day.
As I've said, it's the European fashion to say it, and therefore the correct one.
And I believe the Europeans have the cleanest asses of them all.
Damn straight.
I don't know if that's true, actually. Yeah, so last night, on my personal channel, I finished streaming Eco. This is not the game I want to talk to you about, but Eco. You've played Eco, I'm assuming, right?
Oh, yes. Eco, good old Eco with its two incredibly different box arts, depending on where you're from.
Yes. Played that, had a lovely time. I played that, I was streaming it on my PS3, so I dug out my PS3, and afterwards I was like, what other games do I have on here? And so I played the first hour of a game called Tulip. Have you ever played a game called Tulip?
Oh, yes, I'm very much aware of Tulip.
So I started playing it. Someone mentioned that it was a PS2 game. It came out in Japan during the PS2's life, and then didn't get localized and brought to the West until super late. It was like 2007, and then I think on the PS3 it was just downloadable. But this is the game where it is, you are a poor boy and his father who moved to a new town, and your goal is to kiss everybody in order to gain the confidence to be able to kiss the girl of your dreams. And let me tell you, what a game. I think it's delightful.
Yeah, it's an odd duck.
Yeah.
So it's like Shenmue, except you kiss everything. And
it's just so much kissing. And if they don't want to kiss you, they slap you right in the face, and your heart level goes down.
And everyone's a mascot costume, and there's a weird, excessive exposure of human feces.
Yes, it's great. I'm a big fan of it.
Boy, there's some nice, expensively made cutscenes going on.
This is a very pretty game. Even in non-cutscenes, it's a very pretty game. However, it is a very, it feels oftentimes look, don't touch, like you're going through a museum. Not a whole lot of... This feels linear in the same way Final Fantasy XIII did, in the same way a lot of Final Fantasy X did.
I'll be talking about this in extra punctuation soon, but when I look at a game like this that alternates between incredibly well-produced cutscenes and characters just standing around talking with stock animations, I kind of feel like we should maybe pick on games more for doing that. Sorry, I just want to say that the dude with the lighter hair in this scene would absolutely be played by Sean Bean in the film adaptation.
Is it because he's going to die soon?
Because these cutscenes are all very well, but contrasted against the dialogue sequences, it all seems very... it all kind of takes me out of things. I actually see the workings of the game too much.
Yeah, I mean, it feels like games just haven't... Not all games, but especially AAA games, haven't haven't learned how to deliver long dialogue scenes without it just being two people standing still and gabbing
well,
at each other.
Well, that's the paradox, because we are currently looking at a dialogue scene that is well-directed with nice camera angles and different stances and drama. And then, like, when it cuts to gameplay, all the dialogue scenes are just BioWare face all over the place.
It's tough, because, like, these... I just imagine something like this takes a lot more time and money, and so they, you know, they front-load it, and they make it for important things, but... So much of the game is talking to random people around the hideaway and talking to strangers and doing side quests. And yeah, all of those scenes, even if they're voiced, they're just, it's that BioWare thing, that Bethesda thing that, and I just don't know if there's a way around it. I don't know.
Well, as I say, I'll be discussing this in an upcoming extra punctuation. Oh, look at all these characters I recognize from later in the plot. And who I absolutely did not recognize when I first saw this scene, and it was very confusing.
It is a very heavy dose of exposition in media res right now. And you're like, okay, there's a large man, and there's the angry woman. And she does the cool thing where she lights her cigarette with her finger. That a couple people do well.
Having been replaying Chrono Trigger recently, I really miss sort of nice, straightforward storytelling in console RPGs. It seems all from like Final Fantasy VII onwards, they were all like in medias res. Weird political complex situation thrust into the middle, figure it out as you go things. But Chrono Trigger, it's like, hey, you're a dumb idiot at a fair, you get sent back in time by accident, figure it out, man.
Yeah, I wonder if part of it is in Chrono Trigger you never leave Chrono's point of view until a certain point in the story, and then you go to your party's point of view. It's not like, oh, and here's what the bad guy's doing right now, and oh, here's the political machinations over here.
That lady's not Clive's mum, Isaac Swartz. That's the other lady who looks like Clive's mum.
Benedicta.
Yeah.
If you will. Yeah.
Although I get confused. I thought, like, the dark-haired dude was Clive's dad for a while. Because the dark-haired dude appears in this scene and then, like, disappears for, like, the next 10 hours
for next long time. Yeah, this was I will say I did really appreciate that active time lore thing where you can hit the I think it's just the touchpad on the PS5 and it'll pull up sort of a little web of okay, what are the proper nouns in this scene right now.
We're doing it right now.
Yeah, and this can be helpful. Like, I don't know, on one hand it's like, is your story too convoluted if I need this, but on the other hand I'm like, this is a pretty nice quality of life thing that I think a lot of games could use.
It would be nice if any of these could be, you know, the characters that we're looking at rather than just
it usually is. I don't know. Maybe it's just in this opening scene because we haven't
maybe
been...
these characters haven't officially been introduced yet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd stay asleep if I were you, Tove. Not much been going on for a while.
George Lucas says the Metal Gear Solid Master Collection should outright steal active time lore. That Metal Gear would also be a series that would be pretty good to be able to hit a button.
Trouble with that is, trouble is a Metal Gear, if you open up active time lore, you click on one thing and then be like 9 pages to read through. You know, I think I said this fairly recently to you, but it is refreshing in this game to play a game where the characters fuck.
Yeah. And it doesn't feel like gratuitous, like that, like remember like the what was it, Indigo Prophecy, the David Cage game, where it was like, look, there's a character in the shower and look at this very unerotic lap dance this character is getting. It just feels natural here and non-gratuitous, which is nice. Maybe we're finally getting over that hurdle.
Although I feel like it does all the sex because it's trying to be Game of Thrones.
It's very much trying to be Game of Thrones, yes. Yeah. Game of Thrones and a little bit God of War 2018.
I mean, obviously, Game of Thrones, one could say, is just like generic dark fantasy, medieval fantasy setting, and it's just like taking similar influences. But I think the turning point for me was in the bit in the game where they explain how where Clive's wolf came from.
Oh yeah.
And the story they gave was, oh, we found the puppy by the corpse of its mother on a snowy path. And I was like, oh, for fuck's sake.
That was literally the first episode of Game of Thrones. Yeah, a lot of things that you're just like, wait a minute, what's going on here? Even Clive's mom feels a lot like Cersei Lannister.
Clive's mom is simultaneously being Cersei Lannister and Catelyn Stark, because they're doing the same the hero's mum hates his guts thing.
Yeah, yeah, and almost considers him a bastard. He's not. Yeah. This Clive isn't actually a bastard, but she sort of views him as one.
Yeah, it's kind of weird that.
Yeah.
I think Clive's mum's character is really badly thought out of all the characters in the game.
Yeah, it feels like the game will it'll give you a really interesting moment with a character, and then it'll leave that character for a very long time. Yeah. It's like, what if we focused a little bit more on this person?
And then it's a kaiju battle for 30 minutes, and you wonder why we cared so much about characters talking.
Did the kaiju battles, the big boss battles, remind you of Asura's Wrath at all? Because it reminded me of Asura's Wrath.
Now you mention it. Yeah. Seemed like there was no, like, top. It just kept getting more and more ridiculous.
Yeah, and at a certain point you're like, are you just going to literally destroy this planet? Like, how is anyone going to survive this?
We're just going to destroy the planet now. We have the power to do that. I also think this game's, like, slavery politics conversation is really muddled. Like, everyone hates magic users except the ones that are really powerful, who are in the highest positions of power in the land.
Yeah, you're either, like, literally a slave, or you're considered the cream of the crop if you're one of the, whatever, 8 icon wielders.
Yeah.
And the kind of the in the back half, I haven't finished the game yet, but in the back half, they almost not forget, but they the sort of the slavery class thing goes to the wayside, and it becomes a more traditional use the power of your friends to kill God.
Yeah. The evil god who was making the evil god who was making everybody evil with wibbly wobbly purple badness juice.
Fair, everyone does that now. Like, that's how Tony Stark defeated Thanos, using the power of friendship and snapping.
Friendship will always defeat wibbly wobbly purple badness juice.
What's the best? What's the best example of friendship, of coming together and using friendship to defeat a god?
Earthbound.
The Dragon Ball Z Spirit Bomb, Earthbound, praying to your friends. That's a good one.
Earthbound, 100%. Why do you need to ask?
Yeah. You know what? You know what? I'm a little upset by Mother 3 that didn't get put on your Patreon voted list.
Huh. I guess everyone forgot.
Because
I'd like to play through that. Because I've never actually gotten around to doing so, despite loving Earthbound so much.
I'll give you a reason. Zoe's next year.
Would be nice to have the excuse.
Yeah.
Okay. Did I fuck something up? I can't remember where to go now. It's the literal start of the game.
Right. I think a little to the left. Left. Is there like a little cave here?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I got confused. I wasn't paying attention.
No, I know, because I've played this opening a few times, because I played the demo and then I streamed the demo and then I started the game.
Wow, you must have been really
opening
looking 2 hours. To this
I
game.
Know really well. Well, I just know this opening 2 hours. I know really well. I do think this opening 20-30 minutes, I think, is a little rocky. No pun intended. Right now, but, I didn't mean it. But I do think the sort of the inciting incident, I think, is a really impactful moment. I think this does a good job of making you care about the characters pretty quickly.
Okay, I'm genuinely not sure which specific moment you think is the inciting incident.
When Ifrit first appears. So sort of that initial scene of Ifrit versus Phoenix when you get to
that.
Okay,
we're going to have to go through like 90 million flashbacks before we get
there. I don't even know if we'll get there in the stream.
But, yeah, that's the problem. Yeah.
Goo Bomber, been a member for 11 months. Thank you so much, Goo Bomber. I'm glad Yoshi P got a producer role after saving Final Fantasy XIV. So that's the big story of this game, is that Yoshi P, who helped turn around Final Fantasy XIV with A Realm Reborn, was a producer and one of the creative leads on this game. So
well, it certainly feels like a single-player MMO at times.
Yes, especially when you get to the side quests and when you need to go to an inventory screen to hand over items whose only use is to be handed over, and you're like, why is this screen there?
Yep. I guess they have to make sure you're paying attention.
I
told you before,
you do not get I guess so, yeah.
Isn't Toffee cute?
Aww. What do you think Toffee's favorite game of the year is? Dave the Diver?
Chase the Stuffed Lion.
Oh, someone earlier asked if either of us played Dave the Diver. If you are an Early Access member, you can watch Yahtzee Zero Punctuation right now
on Dave the Diver. There you go. Hey, now we're in Larval Clive form.
it's Charmander Clive?
Yeah. For the combat tutorial.
I think you can skip the tutorial.
Can you? Well, I haven't been playing this game for a few weeks, so could use the refresher.
Purple Marauder, thank you so much. 12 months in the tip jar. How far in the game did you get, Yachts?
I think I got 4 out of 5 elemental crystals destroyed, and then I watched the rest on YouTube.
80%. Close enough.
Yeah, yeah.
Palo Alto, been a member for 6 months in early access. Frick Dave the quote diver.
Why did you put that in quotes? Are you being crude, Peralta?
I don't know. Was that a... I haven't watched your review. I wasn't sure if that was a reference to your review.
Actually, you know what? It's not.
You'll get the hang of it. Just hit this. You're on story mode. Equip those Bengals of
time
hope or whatever.
To introduce all the bloody combat mechanics anyway.
You'll be fine.
We'll just mash attack.
Yeah.
Okay, I got a lore question for you. Who the fuck is Jill?
It is your family's ward, and so your
family.
When did
they tell you that?
I think in an upcoming cutscene, but I learned it from active time lore. So they're not biologically related. It's like again how in Game of Thrones, what was that one guy's name? How the Starks had that one guy who was the ward who ended
Theon
up like
Greyjoy.
Turning on them. Theon Greyjoy. Yeah, yeah. So it's like that, except it would be like if Jon Snow ended up banging Theon Greyjoy at a certain point.
Wait, is she a ward or is she being fostered?
She is a ward, so the two families were in a war, and I believe Clive's family won the war, and as like a sign of like good faith, the other side gave them their daughter.
Yeah, that's what a ward would be.
Yeah. But so she's not like a slave or anything, she's just being raised as one of them.
Yeah, like Threon. Well, the difference is, like, the ward thing is something you do to an enemy. You take one of their children hostage so they don't invade you again. But fostering is something you do with an ally. It was common practice for, like, noble sons and daughters to be fostered with allied households just to give them a taste for the wider world.
But I would imagine there would be a middle ground there of they were enemies in the conflict, but then afterwards as a sign of like, I guess you could say the two sides of the same coin, or we're going to keep her hostage and do so. It will kill her if you, you know, try to invade us again, or as a sign of,
well, I suppose if you have a war and the other side goes, oh, all right, then we admit we were wrong. Let's all have peace now and never be in a fight again. Then I suppose you could switch it from a warding to a fostering situation.
Yeah.
Ned Stark was fostered by Jon Arryn, of course, if we're talking Game of Thrones comparisons.
Have you read the Game of Thrones books? Or just
certainly have. It was Jon Arryn was Ned Stark and Robert Baratheon's second father that he refused to turn them over to the Mad King. And that's what started Robert's Rebellion.
Robert's Rebellion, yeah. And Jon Arryn is the guy who's dead at the beginning. Like in the pilot, you find out he's dead, and that's why.
Yeah.
That's sort of the investigation that leads to
as
that.
You could probably tell, I was a big fan of Game of Thrones, which is why I'm still embittered by the last season.
Are you still a fan of Game of Thrones? Of the like, do you if a new book came out, would you read it? Or when is
no?
The book
I'm embittered by the books in a slightly different fashion.
Is it? I mean, is there any difference between that and to go back to slightly something else? Half-Life 3, like. This never finishing your story.
As someone who's basically been burned too many times and has often found new and interesting things by exploring new areas, I've been known to lose interest in things I used to be really big into if they don't update within enough time.
Understandable. Beastmarch with a $2 dono. Thank you so much.
Jill's way younger. Jill's way younger than Clive in this scene. He bangs her at one point. Cradle snatcher.
It's fine. Everything's fine. No one's crying. Look at that little chocobo claw.
Well, when I asked you who the fuck is Jill, I suppose the follow-up question was, who the fuck is Jill? What is her personality? What are her goals in life? And what is her role in the plot besides convenient thing for Clive to put his mouth on at one point?
Shiva. She's Shiva.
Okay.
The ice goddess.
She's the ice lady.
She is the ice lady.
She's the ice magic thing.
Yeah. At where I'm at in the game, she doesn't have a ton of characterization other than sort of being loyal to Clive.
She has this whole sequence where she takes revenge on the guys who are holding her prisoner for a while. But that's, you know...
Yeah, that is true.
That's just a knee-jerk response to something that was done to her. That's not something that she does.
I do like her character, but I don't... As of the point I'm at in the game, she doesn't have a terrible amount of depth. But I do like her rapport with Clive. Okay. The dude who eats pianos.
Well, I guess
a
plank of wood sits quite evenly on top of another plank of wood.
Was that like a Zen Cohen?
I'm just reminded of a Mark Kermode quote. Oh, he was talking about one of the Pirates of Caribbean films. He's like, oh, is that an Orlando Bloom and Keira Knightley love scene, or is it a nesting table?
Is the situation truly so grave? Womp womp. Did you know Orlando Bloom's going to be in the Gran Turismo movie that comes out next month?
Remember how much little shit I said I gave about something earlier? Well, I give slightly less a shit about that.
About the Gran Turismo movie? The Dude Who Eats Pianos with a $5 dono. Thank you so much, Dude Who Eats Pianos. Why don't they set more fantasy games in a Bronze Age style setting? When are we going to get bored of knights and wards and feudalism? What was different about the Bronze Age? I don't know much about the Bronze Age.
Well, everyone lived in sort of hunter-gatherer tribes, and the dudes with the pointiest swords got to own the most land.
Oh! I mean, isn't that like...
Far Cry Primal?
But yeah! Or like, stuff like, what was that? What's that game that blew up a few years ago? Valheim? I guess that's more like Viking-y, but yeah.
That's like Middle Ages, I'd say.
Yeah. And then Goo Bomber with a $2 dono. Thank you so much, Goo Bomber. Will you check out Lisa the Painful Definitive Edition? That's one of those games people always talk about. Isn't that like an Omori
Undertale-ish? Yeah, it's an Earthbound-inspired game that's very depressing. I've tried playing it once, but never really finished it.
Yeah.
Maybe I got too depressed.
Womp womp.
Chocobos!
Yay!
Weirdly revealing soldier armor. Phoenix will be with us. Why are they all wearing, like, BDSM collars?
You don't know what happens when the sun goes down and the torches are lit. They need to find warmth.
Why isn't anyone wearing pauldrons on both shoulders? You know what pauldrons are for, right?
I don't know what pauldrons are for.
They deflect overhead swings. If your culture is based around sword fighting.
Yeah. It seems like all these cultures are based around sword fighting. Alexander Mason, been a member for 2 months. Thank you so much, Alexander Mason. I was happy not remembering Far Cry Primal. Womp womp. There's rumors that the next Far Cry is going to take place on an island off the coast of North Korea. It was no trouble. I don't have anything other than that.
Isn't that where Just Cause 2 was set in island in the sort of Southeast Asia sort of area?
Yeah. I don't know if it directly had Was it like, did it directly relate to North Korea?
Wait, isn't North Korea landlocked? No, well, South Korea is the one that's like mostly sort of surrounded by ocean.
Yeah.
And then North Korea's north of that doesn't have quite as much coastline.
Who knows? No one knows what's going on in North Korea. Maybe they got their own little sea that we don't know about. Is your lordship's wish? Don't work too hard. Remember,
it is for the good of the duchy that you serve. So, this dude's a magic user, is he?
Correct. Yeah, if you have a facial tattoo, you have the ability to use magic.
I was confused by that, because you never really see people with the facial tattoo use magic.
It's like not very... It's like the facial tattoo is like a brand that marks them as a lower class citizen, and they are ostensibly just a slave. And then sometimes, like when you're wandering around villages, you'll see some that are like churning a water wheel, or some that are like keeping a flame lit. But it's very like...
I noticed people doing that with crystals. Magic. I don't think I noticed any of the branded dudes doing that.
I think all the people doing it with crystals are the branded dudes. I mean, I think the branded dudes... You don't...
No, no, wait. I thought crystals were how you use magic if you're not a branded dude.
I think someone's hungry.
See, here's a water crystal.
Yeah, this is a branded dude.
Yeah, he's branded, but there's a water crystal here. So
I think only certain people can harness the power of the crystals. I don't think the normies can use the crystal power.
No, normies use crystals because they don't have magic in themselves like the branded dudes do.
Mm.
So I don't know what the fuck's going on here.
That's kind of weird then for them to be like, how it's fine for us to do magic if we harness crystals, but you being able to do it without it is just freaky deaky.
But there's a crystal right there, you twat! That's clearly being activated. I don't think all the set designers were clear on this plot.
Dun dun dun.
Nice and quiet in here, isn't it? Shut up, Jill. You're not of age.
You can't tell a child to shut up.
We can snog in 10 years.
I like the rumble in the controller when you have to open a door with R2.
You're easily pleased by the sounds of it.
I think it's the small things in life. Look at the dog. He waved at you.
I can make my dog wave at you if you like that so much. He's kind of resentful of me for it.
I mean, I think Dolphy just wants to sleep. Stop using me as a prop on your stream.
Well, that ship sailed a long time ago, mate. You know what pays for your kibble. Presence, your grace. How may I serve you? All right, you can stop licking my boots. Mother isn't here. Do the territories fare any better?
Most lie under a pall of black. In just these few moons, the blight has taken nigh on all of the northern reaches. It is only a matter of time before it crosses.
Maverick the Wild. Yes, there are several time jumps in the game, and eventually the gray-haired girl is the love interest. Correct.
Yes, you get there's a full-on all the clothes off bang scene. Fairly late in the game.
Sex spoilers.
Yeah, the weird thing is it doesn't start as a sex scene, but they're both completely naked anyway. I think it was one of those, we'd better get out of these wet clothes before we freeze situations.
A lot of sex scenes start. That's a vintage scenario for PG-13 kissing.
Freezing to death is a very convenient scenario for sex. It's like, we better get out of our wet clothes before they freeze on us, and then... You know, moving on from that point, you know the best way to maintain body heat is to share bodily warmth, don't you?
This is one of those things about the Donner Party no one ever talks about, is before they resorted to eating each other, they had an incredible orgy.
Well, you would, wouldn't you?
Yeah. And then afterwards they were like, well, okay, we're not warm enough and we're hungry, so I think we're going to have to start eating.
Gordon.
I live in like Northern California, and if you drive up to like Lake Tahoe, it feels like half the places around there are named after the Donner Party. And it's all you can think
of. A lot of Donner Pass.
It's all you can think of driving through the snowy forest going, man, imagine if I had have to eat my infant children.
That'd be a bummer. The dude who eats piano says, Marty, they were too tired to fuck. They weren't too tired to fuck. They were tired because of the orgy. Like, they shouldn't have had the orgy.
I don't want to spark the usual argument that happens if you complain about everyone being a generic white guy. But for me, the confusing thing is that half the generic white guys have the same fucking hairdo.
Yeah. Agreed.
It's that guy's hairdo, where it's all swept back.
The blonde guy?
I think Paul Hollywood has it as well.
Clive?
No, when I talk about Paul Hollywood, I'm mainly talking about Sid.
That will be all. Sid, that's what I meant. Yeah.
Every time I see Sid, I think it's Paul Hollywood.
I think Sid is a great character.
I think he's going to be criticizing my soggy bottom any moment.
It's a bummer. I don't think we're going to get to Sid on this stream.
Well, we might. We just had to get through this whole dreary flashback. Don't mind me, just retiring to my chambers.
Just trying to figure out where the hell my chambers are.
Everything's so bloody dark in this nice castle.
George Lucas, yeah, Sid is the dad in the Vavitch, and he's also the dude in Diablo 4.
Yeah, it's the big, dude with the very, for him. Very characteristic, extremely deep northern accent.
A great voice. Big fan. Do you own any goblets?
No, I don't.
How do I?
I've got some stemless wine glasses that were here when we moved in.
Not long.
Are they haunted? Or are you worried about them?
No. They're just there.
I like drinking things out of mugs. I feel like mugs are the safest thing to drink. It's got a handle. It's like nice and stout. Wine glasses, I feel like I'm going to tip them over too easily.
Well, that's why it's an experience.
It's part of it's the thrill. Yes, I'm taking
Joshua. Oh, to hell with your way! The boy is ill.
Hey, this is the second of the two kinds of exposition scene. First one is room full of shouting advisors. Second one is two people who are either about to or have just finished shagging.
Mm-hmm. At least this one has nice camera angles.
Clive will watch over him. He is a youth of but 15 years. He's already a fine soldier. He will make a splendid shield.
You see more in him than the Phoenix did. He was rejected.
Yeah, I really don't get why Clive's mum hates him so much.
Yeah, it's like there's like the loose reasons of she wanted, like, he's the strong one, but he's not. He's not the Phoenix dominant.
Well, he still kicks like atomic quantities of ass, is the thing.
Yeah. And it seems very, I mean, we'll get to it probably by the end of the stream, but it seems very reckless of her to be like, I need to take them out of the picture and keep the boy alive. And it's like, your plan was very reckless, lady.
You definitely get the sense that she doesn't think her plans all the way through.
Yeah. Ned Seagoon, been a member for 33 months. Thank you so much, Ned. Holy moly, that's almost 3 years. Time to instead decide the best P5 track. Is it Takeover? Is it Rivers in the Desert? You can only choose one. I mean, Rivers in the Desert is nice because you only hear it in one small slice of the game.
Well, that's cool and all, but Takeover you hear all the time. And the fact that it never stops being fun to listen to, even though you hear it all the time, marks it as the superior song for me.
I like Beneath the Mask when it's raining outside. Okay. Rainy nights, Beneath the Mask playing. Beautiful.
If I'm like procrastinating work and I really want to get pumped up for something, I'll put on either Takeover or Kickstart My Heart.
Those are the big two.
Yeah. Those are the songs that make me go, yes, I'm going to be productive now.
You're going with them tomorrow, aren't you?
I am Joshua's shield. I'm sworn to protect him. He takes too many risks. I only wish I could save him from himself.
I think the
man, they're really
speeding
through the characterization here, aren't they?
I'm gonna need to linger. This isn't the main time period. We're gonna jump forward.
Clive was literally just describing his personality to someone.
Well, you don't do that to people. You don't do that to your semi sisters.
Not generally, no. But then, I'm a taciturn sword.
There you go.
Well, damn, she's killing the mood with all this religious shit. Probably saving it till marriage. Isn't
there? Since coming here, I've begun to take peace for granted. I assume.
Oh, okay, there you go. There was a war between their nations.
Yeah.
But it never really ends, does it?
Come on, Active Time Lord, what you got? That's not how you spell Warwick.
Like Warwick Davis?
Yeah, it's Warwick.
Yeah?
As in Warwickshire, the county I grew up in.
Ooh.
Okay, yeah, it's just a straight hostage situation by the sounds of it.
But it's like a kind hostage.
Yeah.
Positive hostage.
Yeah, but Theon's dad was still mad about it.
Yeah, that dude is a dick. The next war will be bigger than before.
But you'll be all right, won't you, Clive? You're a shield of Rosaria, after all, and blessed by the Phoenix.
Yes, Fungus Finder, they're being raised as siblings, but... they'll be parted by circumstance, and they meet back up 10 years later, and eventually bang. It's getting
cold. We should go in.
Spoiler alert.
My lady.
Thumbs up.
Good night, Clive.
That is true, Jumble. I'm sorry I called Theon a dick when he had his removed. My apologies.
Well, he was kind of a twat, Theon.
He was. He's a bad dude. He turned his back on his family.
But he wasn't a bad dude. He was just wasn't a very smart dude.
No. Just wanted his dad to love him. Everything about Game of Thrones is just everyone wants their dad to love him.
Except for that one Dornish lady who stabbed Dr. Bashir to death. Yeah, that's another thing I'm bitter. The TV series made me bitter about. They really did fucking Doran Martell up the
jacks. They did him dirty? Yeah.
They did him, both Doran Martell, the character, and Dr. Bashir, the actor, dirty. Because I like Alexander Siddig. I heard he was being cast in Game of Thrones. I was like, good on you, Dr. Bashir. Let's see who you have a slightly homoerotic on-screen relationship with this time.
Then he quickly gets stabbed to death. You're like, oh, dang.
Yeah.
As Grace departs, open the gates.
So you know that guy's not going to survive the plot. He's got too generic a face.
What are we doing? Oh, this is the part where we're gonna go to the swamp. We gotta fight goblins in the swamp and then fight all a big old Marlboro cigarette. I shall safely to Phoenix Gate. Marlboro. Thank you. Marlboro? Marlboro?
Marlboro?
Marlboro?
Marlboro? Marlboro?
Is it... Do you pronounce the L or the R first? Marl or Malra? Oh my god.
Oh,
I can't
look,
say it anymore.
Two guys, it looked like they were randomly rolled by a character creator.
Do you think... Giant misstep on their part of missed opportunity of not calling these guys Biggs and Wedge.
I genuinely thought they were going to introduce themselves as Biggs and Wedge when they showed up.
I feel like, why not do that? That's been a thing that Final Fantasy's done all the time. Call these guys Biggs and Wedge.
When was the last Final Fantasy game that actually had a Biggs and Wedge in?
That's actually a good question. 8?
Yeah, I remember the Biggs and Wedge in 8. Wasn't there a Biggs and Wedge in...
I mean, 7 Remake 10, have them.
In 10-2.
Ooh, probably 10-2, yeah.
Oh, 9 had a Biggs and Wedge.
Oh, yeah. 14. Yeah, 14.
Well, I
assume 14, doesn't
14
count.
Has a Biggs and Wedge, because, you know...
Oh, 15 had Biggs and Wedge? Who were Biggs and Wedge in 15?
I don't remember Biggs and Wedge in 15.
I don't know. Maybe your car is named Biggs and Wedge.
Hey, who likes overworld travel? This game doesn't. Here's a fucking map screen.
Hey. This game, plot-wise, location-wise, even overworld map screen-wise, a lot of shades of the Evil East games. So Final Fantasy Tactics, Final Fantasy XII, The Vagrant Story.
If you say
feels
so.
Of a piece with those.
Don't worry, we'll be getting into combat at some point soon.
You gotta fight some goblin-ass goblins. Oh yeah. My god, if you told me point to a goblin, the goblins in these games, very goblin-y.
What's your step, my lord? I guess.
They are. You're gonna see when they pop up.
More goblin-y than the goblins in Peter Jackson's Lord of the Rings trilogy, which were just orcs, but thinner.
Yeah, those were not good goblins. Timely accessories.
I probably won't be equipping those. Yeah, this just lets you button mash through combat. Ah, what the fuck. Oh, nice sprite art of all the characters in the bottom right there.
I think it's cute. Save screen has those as well. Did you laugh at the name of the Ring of Timely Strokes? Because I did every time I saw it.
The Ring of Timely Strokes.
Exactly. Yeah, that's a ring.
I had a few timely strokes this morning.
Ah! Badooch. Tongue cranking.
Okay, I remember now.
The old village of Stillwind is ahead.
It feels weird to have a dodge and a different dodge. When you've got the...
Yeah, you have like a dodge and attack, and then you have like a close the distance kind of dodge.
Yeah, what kind of threw me is that depending on what magic you've got equipped, much, much later in the game, incidentally, then the circle button does different things.
Yeah, like yeah. Phoenix is the dodge one, whereas
when
like
you got
Titan
fire
like
equipped, you got dodge. I think with wind, you...
It's like a kind of like a grappling hook that pulls them towards
yeah.
you.
So it's all about enemy positioning. And getting closer to enemies, but then with lightning, it's just an attack.
That one is really annoying because I'll forget that I'm not on Phoenix, and I'll hit circle, and then it'll go into that slow mo first thing. I'm like, I don't care about this. I don't need to use this.
Yeah, it throws me whenever I have a magic where the circle isn't some kind of traversal move.
Yeah.
Goblins.
Goblins. Goblin ass goblins.
Actual goblins. They don't belong to any warring medieval faction or whatever. They're
there's
with
me. There's a... I can't remember if it's a side quest or just like a smaller part of the normal quest later on with some friendly goblins. And I like that there's some nice goblins in the world. They just want to gob out. Like they're not here to kill anyone. They just want to gob out.
Wow. So is story mode just the mode we have turned on when we made all the gameplay trailers? There may be more.
So that everyone could look really cool.
That was some pretty impressive combat.
Yeah.
I was just mashing attack.
Yeah, there you go.
For the record, I played in action mode when I was actually playing the game for review. And there's a bit more nuance to the combat there. But I guess it doesn't matter so much because the audience don't care.
Nah, it's all about looking cool.
Welcome to Stillwind. Have care, my lord.
Hi, goblin mugger.
There's more.
What do you want now, tutorials? Yes, I understand loot. The concept of loot.
Hot loot.
I feel like you didn't need to tell me that.
Never played a game of loot before.
Ah, the fucking auto combat thing used up my magic attack without me asking.
Oh no.
Maybe I'll turn auto combat off at some point.
Yeah, I think that's just those the rings of broken out you got. Yeah, there is like there's a crazy hard difficulty mode. People in the chat are talking about called Final Fantasy mode. That is only on New Game Plus.
I assume you have to play through it once to get that.
Yeah.
Sometimes they have a crazy hard difficulty mode that's just we delete your save if you die, which is cheaters super hard difficulty mode.
Yeah. We were talking sort of the Iron Man mode in XCOM, or like I think The Last of Us had a mode called Grounded that was that same thing, like a permadeath mode.
Yeah,
that doesn't seem enjoyable to me whatsoever.
Where are we going? That way.
Yeah, Andrew Brown, it's I don't know how I feel about locking really tough difficulty modes behind having to finish the game. It's not as bad as there are certain games I know that have locked easy modes behind having to finish it, which seems just incredibly fucking weird to me.
I think it was Devil May Cry that only unlocked easy mode if you fucked up enough times.
Yeah.
And the game takes pity on you.
I know there was like a Pocky and Rocky remaster a year or two ago, and in order to unlock the easy mode, you had to like get a huge amount of currency to buy it in the shop. And I'm like, this seems strange.
If you're at that point, you probably don't need it.
Yeah.
Should be nearing the old village square. It might not be a nest of goblins.
The Mr. Grumpykins, welcome to Early Access. Thank you so much, Mr. Grumpykins.
Welcome, Mr. Grumpykins.
You can check out the ZP on Day of the Diver. You could check out episode 2 of Frost's new series of Stuff of Legends. And on Saturday, you could check out episode 1 of season 3. The adventure is Nyai.
We just had a bonus behind the scenes video drop for certain tiers.
Ooh. Yeah, I actually don't know what that video was. I just saw people talking about it.
You haven't exploited your insider status?
I'm not, no.
Watch things ahead of time.
Is it just a bunch of behind-the-scenes videos of Milwaukee? Because I've lived that. I've lived the Milwaukee dream.
No, it's four of us trying to figure out what to do for a behind-the-scenes video.
Oh, clever. A little meta video right there.
Smash, 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 smash.
Commentator, I'm not technically paywalled because I can go into a Google Drive that has all the finished videos and watch them.
Don't you have access to the members' Discord?
I do. Nick didn't put the link in there, though, did he? Because I think it was only... I think that video was only for $5 tier and above, I want to say. It wasn't just the $2 tier.
Yeah, I've only seen it because he posted it on the internal Adventurers Nye Slack page.
Yeah, that's right. Which I'm not a part of. recipes.
Oh boy, partial stagger.
Ooh. What did you think of the combat in this game?
Okay, it got pretty boring. But I like the mid game. Feels like the enemy health bar is very spongy. It was just hitty, 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 hit, and hit, and hit, and hit.
What'd you think of the bosses? Which I guess we might get to one. Well, I guess we're about to do never gonna be able to say that name. Did you like sort of the big set PC fights against the various icons and whatnot?
No, I sort of glazed over when that was happening because, as I said in the review, it's impossible to tell if this is the actual fight for real Z's, or if they're just going to pull out another final form afterwards.
It gave me, I mentioned Asura's Wrath earlier, but it also gave me a lot of the game has heavy Attack on Titan and even some Neon Genesis Evangelion vibes. And as a fan of all those,
if you like,
I was fine with it. I do like. Guglop, welcome to Early Access, Guglop.
Feel we overdo the tutorial messages sometimes.
A lot of tutorial messages here.
Hey, here's a rundown of the thing you're currently looking at that's pretty self-explanatory.
Goblins. More goblins.
Fight, you coward! After him, before he summons the rest.
The accents in this game are all over the place.
We don't know what the regional dialects of this world are like.
You'd be like a single region with like five different regional British accents on display.
The dude who eats pianos, $2 dono. Which is more brown, this or Call of Duty? I didn't think this game was very brown.
This is looking a bit blue at the moment.
Yeah, and you go to different areas in the game that are much different colors. I would not put this.
Yeah, it's not really a brown game. It's a gritty game.
Ooh.
This ends now.
Oh no, poor goblin.
Oh man, he got Jurassic Worlded.
Did I, that poor woman in Jurassic World.
Yeah, that always sort of stuck with me.
She's just trying to take care of those kids and they just give her the meanest death.
I think there might have been some like cut scenes that made it more justified the way I
Yeah.
Heard. You know what? I'm sick of it preempting me. I ain't the kind of gamer that wants things to be auto-fought for me.
Oh, it's the Ring of Timely Strikes. I thought it was the Ring of Timely Strokes. Oh, unable to change gear while in combat.
Bummer. Well, bugger you then, game.
Bummer.
Yeah, you'd better be staggered.
Yeah, at least on this mode, it's taking on their health pretty quickly. Total Reset says, shouldn't these be played in Japanese?
Well,
head however you want.
Wasn't it the case that this, like, the game was made in English from the beginning?
I would imagine so.
In this case, because Final Fantasy has always been more popular in the West than in Japan.
That's true. That's
well, it's never been as popular as Dragon Quest in Japan. Mm. I know that much.
your things are.
Oh, hey, got to stop for a tutorial for how QuickTime events work. You've never seen those bloody things before.
QTEs. QTEs. Yeah, Tyrell, the lip sync is for English, so... Also, play however you want to play. Watch anime however you want to watch anime.
Let's get one of those drinking bird toys to press the square button for me. Remember when auto fire was a thing on game controllers?
I do. I had a Super Nintendo auto fire controller. Speaking of Chrono Trigger, I used that as a child to be able to beat the at the Millennium Fair. There was a beer drinking minigame.
Oh, I won that without needing an auto fire at all.
Oh well, I saved my thumb strength by using auto fire.
You don't use your thumb; it's all in the technique.
You do
you get your index finger and you get it nice and tensed up, and you just go like you're in the Vinegar Strokes.
Raphael says, I love how we as gamers moved away from QTEs because they were dull and stupid, and now we praise Final Fantasy 16 for having them. Us saying that they were dull and stupid was a mistake. I replayed Asura's Wrath last month, and that game fucking rules, and we were idiots for saying anything bad about that and about Metal Gear Rising Revengeance.
I ain't praising like shit. QuickTime events are terrible. It. I hate them.
QTEs rule. QTEs are fucking rule. They're great. Give me more QTEs.
You're stupid.
Give me more QTEs. Give me them cuties.
Oh, he's about to do that thing again. Hey, this isn't a Marlboro, it's a Marlboro.
Marlboro.
Can't you read?
Marlboro. Oh! First off, it's very small. I thought it said strokes earlier as well, so I don't know what's going on.
Da 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 da.
I love when you get that the fanfare that's in like the choir. Very cool.
I like singing that song every time a good character dies.
A beloved character dies.
Yeah, they have the heartwarming scene. They fade to black, and then I just go da 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 da.
Goblins in Rosaria, but more balls too.
I got some more balls for you.
Ah,
perhaps you'd like some more balls.
Fewer balls.
Yeah, go back to sleep, Toph. Do that really cute thing where you stick just the little tip of your tongue out the front of your mouth.
Oh, the little bleps.
He's not doing it right now.
If I'm not mistaken, I saw someone post that not only are the QuickTime events in this game not quick, but you cannot fail them. If the circle runs out, it just starts again.
Does it?
Next time, if you get to a QTE, if we get to another boss fight, try that out. Don't hit the button and see what happens.
I never tested that. I know in No More Heroes 2, they had like QuickTime event things where the action would slow down. And the button prompt would come up, but if you didn't press anything, the action would just keep slowing down until it came to a complete halt.
It just wouldn't move on until you hit the button.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're ITEs, infinite time events. Exactly.
There you go. Some time later. Nice descriptive prose there.
Is it because they don't have, like... minutes and hours in this world? No, they have years, right?
Yeah. Wait till you hear this. Wait till you hear this. And there's a day-night cycle.
There is a day-night cycle. This is true. The goblin chief runs off screaming. Straight down on Marvel's gut. Cade Brockhausen with a $5 dono. Thank you so much, Cade. About today's early ZP, Dave the Diver is handsome. I like that there is a fat main character who isn't treated like a massive joke.
Well, he kind of is, just not for being fat.
He's suffering under the gig economy. He's got to have a lot of jobs. I feel bad for a dude.
I just think
of him as a sort of work all day and then work all night.
I just think of him as the sort of weak-willed dude who has trouble saying no to people.
Isn't that just a hero, though? He doesn't say no because he's a hero.
Well, then, in that case, I am a hero when my wife makes me take the kids to the park.
You're a hero for being a father, for being a present father.
There you go. I am the ninja and everyone's dad.
Are you unwell?
No, father. Just a little tired.
But where are all the wenches at this serving bar full of burly soldiers?
Maybe it's it's like a buffet. You have to go up and refill your own tankards and plates.
So there's a little fenced off area where the wenches are.
Yeah.
Like the mosh pit
and stuff. The wench pit.
Yeah, the wench pit. I mean, I feel like there's a limit to how rowdy men in this sort of setting can get without wenches, you know. Because
sure.
A lot of this is for the wench's benefit. A lot of this sort of posturing.
Yeah.
Get the men together and they just want to like play chess and read books and stuff.
Yeah, just dudes being dudes. Joshua, blessed to be a dominant, to wield the power of an icon. Hunter says, can you pet the wolf? You can.
Yes, not for another decade though.
You can't bet him when he's a dog, but you can bet him when he's a wolf.
That's a point. Torgal's probably really elderly by the end of this game.
Yeah, he's kind of magical, though, so we don't know what...
He'd be like 15, 16?
But he's like he's a magic dog. Like, we don't know how long they last, right?
I suppose. Well, larger dogs, if anything, have shorter lifespans than small dogs.
Is that true? I didn't know that.
Yeah, like Chihuahuas live like 15 years. And
yeah, I guess that's true. When you see real old-ass dogs, they're usually small.
And shit like your English Mastiff only gets like 7-8 years on average. So if you got a great big war dog, it'd probably live like 5 years tops. Remember Andre the Giant? He died young.
He did. He's the large dog of humans.
That's what tends to happen with larger than average people. Yeah. I've thoroughly...
Are you worried?
Yeah, well, I've made it clear to my wife, so she wouldn't be too surprised by it.
Poor Jill. She'll be wondering where you got to. So much for you being a fine hound.
I'm 6'5", the dude who eats pianos. It's mostly in my legs, though. If I'm sitting down, I'm usually a similar height to everyone around me. What are you doing out here?
Just got a very long lower torso. Feasts are the only time shields are allowed to take their ease, and
I've never really been one for cakes and ale.
It's the vegetables I don't like.
Why does this scene giving me vibes of that early scene in Game of Thrones where Tyrion leaves the party and talks to Jon Snow outside?
Yes. Same.
Let me give you some advice, bastard.
I never used to. When I joined the ranks, everyone thought I was a spoiled little lordling. If I didn't know how to handle a sword, I'd be a laughing stock. Archduke's firstborn failure.
I think this game does this opening couple hours does a really good job of making you care about the relationship between these two. You're heartless.
Yeah.
You don't care about any relationships in games.
Not true.
Except
I enjoyed getting my Lego verandas in Dragon Age 2. My brother the Phoenix. Ruler of a life. And the relationship in Prince of Persia Sands of Time is really good. I did a whole video on it and everything.
That's true. You like that one. You like James Sunderland's relationship with his own grief.
Well, yes, but that's a different flavor of emotion, I suppose. I guess I sort of don't really like little boys as characters.
Okay, glad there was more words after that.
Because I really hated that the kid in the Plague Tale games as well.
He's voiced by the same kid. They're the same voice.
Serious?
Right here. Yeah.
You'd think he'd have like aged a few years.
Yeah.
In the meantime. Well, maybe they've been developing this game for a few years. Are you serious?
I am. Yeah.
Man. Like child actors, you've only got usually only get like a couple of years of work out of them before the balls drop.
Maybe he maybe this was recorded a long time ago, so he got his lines in early.
Well, I assumed as much from the fact that it's obviously trying to crib off Game of Thrones. I mean, clearly it was made quite a few years ago before everyone went off that.
I mean, that's always the funny thing with how long things take to get made. It's like, oh, this is a cool thing of the moment. Let's start this and be inspired by this. And then 7 or 8 years later, you're like, oh, how do people feel about it now?
Toffee's just got one fang sticking out. I don't know if you can see it. But it's very cute.
Aww. I should go inside. It's past my bedtime. Good night,
Torgle. Excuse me. No, oh, what a cutie.
Look at that dog.
Yes, old under 77. That's why they often cast middle-aged women to voice boys. As in Bart Simpson and Ash in the Pokemon cartoon.
Yep.
Supplies from the capital.
What could possibly go wrong? I bet they're just bringing in more food and goodies for the the party.
I think they're bringing in some supplies for the crimson shaded wedding that might be going on.
Oh no!
It's a good job the North is full of enterprising traders keen to keep us in wine.
Spare a barrel for the boys in duty.
Gumbly says, why don't they eat chocobos ever? I mean, I'm sure they do in a pinch. It's probably like horses or
yeah.
With us. Like, people eat horses. It's not common, but...
Yeah, there's a bit of a societal stigma against eating horses because horses are our loyal friends and beasts of burden.
Yeah. Oh no, this isn't going to be good.
Secured, Captain. We proceed as planned. Oh no, it's a bunch of bastards.
Oh no.
Snoozy puppy.
I like the sound design in this moment where it bleeds from, it's clearly like everyone's having a good time, and then it sort of just slowly morphs into, oh no, that good time sounds like murder.
Yeah. I can't hear it very well, I got the sound down. Mm.
Isaac, not only it is the trigger number from Final Fantasy IV, and you just wait. There'll be an even more overt reference to Final Fantasy IV coming up soon.
It's me, Wade. You probably don't remember me.
I remember. What is it?
We're under attack. I don't know who they are, but they've set light to half the castle. I must get you to safety, Your Highness.
Very well. I'm ready.
Follow me, Your Highness.
Oh, can we unequip those fucking rings now?
Oh my god, this is the first time you've had control since then.
I guess not, because we're controlling the other fucking characters.
I guess because you're not technically, yeah. Aw, it's a little floating fireball. That looks nice.
Are you joining the waking world, Tovey? Yes? No? Yawn? Maybe?
Pain scream.
Yeah, what was that? It was a pain scream, can't you read?
Yeah.
Everything's on fire.
Fall back, Your Highness. He's not one of us.
No. I must do my
Now you mention it, I'm hearing the little snot wipe from the Playtale games.
Yeah, I feel like once you start to hear it, you're like, oh, I can't not hear it now.
Yeah.
Obviously, I'm assuming it's a different actor when he's, you know, after the time jump. Spoilers. There's a time jump. Spoilers, there's several time jumps.
Guess his parents are trying to get as much money out of him as they can for the ball drop scenario. Or maybe they just cut his balls off.
Jesus.
They used to do that.
Yeah, Gold not now.
Castrato.
Damn it, the bastards are everywhere.
Why would the Empire do this? They're our allies.
Toffee, you're making the whole couch jiggle.
Toffee making the whole couch jiggle?
Yes.
How? Yeah. So small.
If the couch is rocking,
oh no!
Don't come a knocking.
Oh no! Magical Gaming, how long have we been playing? 1 hour and 15 minutes.
Yeah, and the inciting incident that Marty mentioned may be happening at some point in the next.
I think we'll get to it by the end of the stream. I think we'll get to it by the end of the stream.
Damn it! His wounds are deep.
This big stroke wedge dude is really selling his lines. Sounds like he's doing a high school play.
Uh-huh.
Damn it, his wounds are deep.
Don't worry. They're going to be all right.
I'll hold them off.
Why has he got the hair of someone from a 70s boy band?
It's called fashion. Look it up.
It looks like he's in the Monkees.
Does look like he's in the Monkees. Oh no. There's our boy.
Oh, it's just a Clive.
Our sweet Clive.
Clive and Josh. Don't worry, all the generic-faced guys will be dead by the end of this thing.
No, we don't know that. Maybe they'll survive. One survives, right? I think one shows up later on again.
Well, the main
guy. Yeah, this guy does. This guy shows up later on.
I was trying not to spoil.
Oh. Spoilers. You spoiled way bigger things from later on in the game.
What, you mean the fact that the main character and the main love interest have sex at one point?
Yeah, but we don't know that.
I'm sure that's a big spoiler.
We don't know that.
It's a spoiler to say that a love interest is a love interest. Not ravens, owls. It's different.
And they're cool magical owls.
Yeah, it's like we're ripping off Harry Potter, not Game of Thrones.
It reminded me of the owls in Clash of the Titans? I think the old like 80s movie.
Didn't that have like robot owls?
It was like a robot owl. They kind of looked robotic. Its eyes turned glazed over.
That's just crystal the animation, I think. And straight back to sleep. Nighty night, Toph.
I remember, which is why I'm going to hold the enemy here while you make. Magical Gaming, we have both played it. This is these weekly streams are they accompany the review of the game.
Yes. So I've already played the game and posted my zero punctuation review of it, which went out today on YouTube. And now I'm illustrating the points I made in the review by showing off the first 2 hours of the game. That's basically the whole premise.
And I'm here to say, no, you're wrong. And it's actually fine to have children in video games.
And tell me off for bargo busting now and again.
Oh no, for the occasional bargo busting. And to bring up Tulip.
Yeah. Yeah, this moment specifically made me think, this is one of those, these characters are never going to meet again, or not for like decades of time.
Oh, the ominous door closing? Yeah, what could possibly go wrong?
That was definitely the vibe I was getting. Oh boy, things to kill.
Oh. They were trying to steal your tables.
How dare you? We got them from IKEA. Me and Dad put them together over the weekend. It was a real bonding experience.
We're too late. Everyone's dead.
Oh, hi.
I don't know how many big old Final Fantasy fans are in the chat, but what are your guys's what do you hold as the pinnacle of the series? Which ones do you put on top?
I still think 9's underrated.
I think all I'm a big 5, 6, 7, 9. 12 is my number one. Got a lot of 6s, 8, a 12, a 10, a 7, a lot of those middle ones.
Though I've been going back to the 16-bit groove, I think Chrono Trigger was better than 6.
I completely agree. Chrono Trigger is kind of in a class of its own.
Oh, forgive me, game.
How did that feel? How did it feel in the controller? It felt nice, I bet.
It felt like I pressed a button and a thing happened, which is the baseline of what you should expect. Captain. That guy's eyes must be very close together.
I just also feel like it'd be very hard to, like, your peripheral vision would be terrible.
Excuse me.
Fungus Finder says, why is your side so weak? Because they're all fucking drunk. They're just drunk, and they were there. It's like 3 in the morning, and all of a sudden, someone kicks in the door and starts stabbing you.
Dramatically drawing the sword is like the medieval equivalent of the pointless cocking of the gun when you point it at someone in movies.
Yeah, but it looks sick.
You look sick.
Thank you.
You should see a doctor.
Oh, no.
That's them done. Are you all right? I'm fine.
I like this scene coming up with the Dragoon, because he looks like Kane from Final Fantasy IV. It's very cool looking. Look at this guy. This guy looks fucking sick. Hell yeah. Look at him. Look at him.
Yeah, this is where the overlap between anime and gritty...
Wait,
real,
oh shit,
gritty
I was going to say don't do anything.
Oh, sorry, I forgot. There'll probably be another
one. I'm not going to remember. Yeah.
Yeah, the relationship between anime and gritty realistic medieval fantasy, a little bit awkward.
Do you think they're at odds with each other
in moments like these?
Yeah.
Hey, stop it, you bastard.
Stay still, damn you.
Damn it.
Captain President with a $10 dono. Thank you so much, Captain President. Remember, your donations now are all going towards Adventures Nigh Side Quest Season 3. Part 3? I don't know what we call side quests.
I guess it's just Side Quest Season 3.
Side Quest Part, yeah. How you differentiate that. But yes, the third season of Side Quest. Captain President, $10 dono, thank you so much. How disappointed would you be as a trained elite knight that can jump higher than a building to be killed by a 14-year-old with a sword? Oh no, what's gonna happen? Oh, okay, something did happen. Oh,
hey,
you did lose.
Yeah.
Okay.
The person you were listening to was talking shit.
The internet lied to me. I've been once again lied to by the internet.
Trying to do a fancy dodge, but it didn't work out. I think it might be because, like, the audio is slightly out of sync in my earphones because of the way my capture card works. That's my excuse, and I'm sticking with it.
Do you still have your weird rings equipped?
No, I took them off.
Gotcha.
I need to fail on my own terms.
John, only one game every year is legally allowed to have weapon degradation, and Tears of the Kingdom already snagged that spot, so no. No weapon degradation here.
Hey, ability finish, no less.
Oh no, the Knight of Blinding Dawn.
Level loop.
Fungus Finder, there was a Final Fantasy anime like 20 years ago that was very bad.
Are we talking about?
There's also Advent Children. Well, there's a movie, there was an anime.
I didn't know there was an anime.
It was very bad, and I believe it got canceled during its first season.
Wasn't there a
Final Fantasy it was released
VII?
Around.
Wasn't there a CG movie related to
yes.
Final Fantasy VII at some point?
Advent Children.
Yeah, that's the one.
And then there was a Final Fantasy XV CG movie called Kingsglaive.
Oh yes, that was like a parallel to the game.
Yeah, it almost like accompanied it because it was like what was going on before.
Yeah, what was going on with the actual plot while you were pissing about in a car.
Yeah. Beastmarch's $2 dono. We need the funding goal counter on the screen. You all have to keep. We assume you all have notebooks at home and you keep track. And every time, it's almost like keeping scorebooks at a baseball game. What is that? Listen. You know what? At least we got the name Final Fantasy spelled right on the overlay.
Hey.
I don't know if you know. Final Fantasy is not spelled correctly on the overlay.
What?
On the overlay, Final Fantasy is not spelled correctly.
Is it not?
No, it's got two L's in final. I thought that might be a Britishism.
Oh, well, that was actually a typo that I missed. But
no.
Whatever, we're just going to live with it now.
It's fine. Yes, Captain President, this is Timothy Chalamet plays young Clive. Correct.
I feel like I've been hearing that name a lot lately.
Timmy Chalamet? He's playing Wonka in the Willy Wonka prequel film.
Yes, yes. I remember hearing about that.
He's also Jimmy Dune, and he's the main character of Dune. Paul Atreides. You just leave? You're just sick of this game? You just walk? Oh, no, you're changing the over. Final Fantasy Climb!
There. Is that better?
I think it's great. Oh, no! Dad got killed.
Oh, that was a bad time to not be paying attention.
Dad got killed.
That's okay. I played it before. Also, he was a dad in Game of Thrones, so he obviously wasn't going to live.
Yeah, Old Thunder. You also played Name and Call Me By Your Name. Yeah. You must do your duty. You played Young Interstellar in Interstellar.
I don't think that was his name.
Call Me By Your Name. Or Young Interstellar.
Interstellar. I think the dude had a name.
His name was
Cooper. Hey, flashbacks to things we just saw.
Yay, just in case you forgot.
See, there's no reason the dude who did all that wouldn't have known this would happen. Because he knew the kid was the Phoenix icon, or however you say that.
Yeah, I guess I don't know if it explains, like, is it like a puberty thing? Like at a certain point you go through, or like a ritual is usually supposed to unlock the Phoenix? They didn't realize that trauma would unlock.
We knew he already had devastating magic powers because he used it on enemy soldiers earlier when we were controlling.
Yeah. Yeah, at the very least, he could just like throw fireballs at everyone, which seems like a bad idea.
You'd think that murderer would have been a little more cautious of that.
Yeah. Alexander Mason with a $2 dono. Thank you so much. Obligatory reminder of Clive Barker's Jericho.
Yeah. I know Americans only know two Clives, Clive Owen and Clive Barker.
We know this Clive is now, so I know three Clives now.
And this one, Clive Rosfield.
That's cool, man.
Doesn't that just literally mean Redfield? Isn't his name just Chris Redfield?
Oh, we got it. And he's got Jill. And he's in love with Jill. Oh,
hey, man. I think we've decoded it. Get her on her feet and run. Please. Do Americans know Clive Anderson? He's like a British dude.
I don't know Clive Anderson.
He was the original British host of Whose Line Is It Anyway? When that was a British show.
To be honest, I didn't even know it was a British show. I thought Drew Carey created it.
I'm sure that's what Drew Carey says.
Classic Drew Carey erasure.
I don't think there's a single, like, big twist in this game I didn't predict. Like, the identity of the other monster that's going to show up in this scene. Was that supposed to be a surprise?
They spoiled it when we learned it? Trailer. They spoiled it in like the pre-release trailers.
Oh,
so,
okay. Well, I didn't see the pre-release trailers.
Yeah. Second icon of fire.
That's impossible. Rip, generic faced man.
Yeah.
We shall not see your like again. I think we meet his wife later.
We do, yeah. Heavy breathing. Tom Holland? Welcome to Early Access.
Not the real one, I assume.
I mean, I'm sure this Tom Holland is a real Tom Holland.
Well, you know, he might be the real Tom Holland. Maybe. Tom Holland likes to unwind watching Final Fantasy streams.
Yeah. And supporting creators like ourselves.
Tom Holland is of an age that he might be nostalgic for zero punctuation videos.
There you go.
And
guys,
here we go again.
We're back at the start.
I'll piss off, tutorial.
You need to learn how to embody the Phoenix.
I hate this sort of shit. I think it's really patronizing. Press the buttons to continue the cinematic monster fight. You're the one doing this. No, really.
I think it looks sick.
I think it looks sick when they can pull off this sort of thing in actual game mechanics. Like beating the boss fights in Metal Gear Rising Revengeance made me feel sick. In many senses of the word.
Uh-huh. Yeah, Tyrael. Oh,
look, we fell into the set of Dark Souls.
Oh no!
What was that doing
there? We're
gonna
find a poison swamp. We're gonna find a poison swamp.
No, no, we're going down to the Great Hollow. We are.
Oh no!
We're gonna hang out in the Ash Sea or whatever it was called.
Oh no! The unfinished area.
Yeah, with the dragon at the end of it. Ash Lake, that was it.
Ash Lake, that's right. Got a little Hydra down there.
Yeah, a knockoff Hydra.
Yeah,
because the other Hydra was busy. Yeah, as I say, these are definitely the bits where I zone out. At this point, the action does the action not feel kind of meaningless at this point? It's just monsters hitting each other. It's just turned into a Michael Bay Transformers movie.
I mean, it just feels like a big kaiju fight, which, I don't know. Do you like when big monsters fight each other? I guess that's literally maybe like your mileage may vary based on like, do you like King of the Monsters or?
I'm more interested in tense character moments, if I'm honest.
Mm.
Yeah. I'm sure you can lose this fight. I'm going to endeavor not to, so we don't have to sit through this whole fucking thing again.
Uh-huh.
Aha! Whatever that was, I dodged it.
You did a precision dodge. Very, very proud of you.
Yeah, I'm sure the dudes in the orchestra are getting very adrenalized. they're going nuts.
It's going wild.
Yeah, the choir's probably going to have a bit of a lie down after this.
You're going to need a lozenge afterwards.
Ha! Huh. 3 precision dodges.
Oh my god. In this economy?
Okay, now let's see what happens if we don't press square.
I was just lied to. Oh! You seem
well, fine. I don't think we lost any health.
No, maybe you didn't do any damage? I don't know.
Maybe that was our opportunity to do some damage that we lost. Although I guess it doesn't matter so much. Because we're awakening, regardless.
Henry says, can't wait to watch this game on YouTube. I feel like you can wait. Because you could have been watching this game on YouTube for like
well,
the
you
past
kinda
month.
Are watching this game on YouTube as we speak.
I guess anytime you anytime you watch us play any game, you're watching it on YouTube. Remember Twitch? Remember the old days when we used to stream on Twitch?
Stream on what?
We don't talk about it anymore.
Doesn't ring a bell.
We don't talk about that? Oh no! How are you gonna be able to stop this? He's throwing a big old fiery spirit bomb with a countdown.
Oh, what do you know? I won.
I'm proud of you. I was worried.
What a good job I did.
Simple Simon with a $10 dono. Thank you so much, Simple Simon. Final Fantasy 16, the movie that plays like a game. Having toffee time for the whole stream kind of makes up for it. But it's like a weird, like one of those streams where you just watch someone sleep.
If only Toffee were aware of it. If only Toffee were aware of his status in the eyes of the watching public. Only Toffee weren't a giant hairy slug.
Oh, Toffee the slug. And Super Beef with a $10 dono. Thank you so much, Super Beef. Hey guys, finished Amori the other day and searched for a ZP on it and found the stream you guys had on it. Really enjoy it. Curious if y'all played any further. The ending was excellent.
No. Womp. Who's got time for that? Though I have been continuing to replay System Shock 2 since we streamed it.
Oh. Well, there you go.
Because I like the game. Sue me.
I would never.
Yay, we won.
Or did we?
Well, the Phoenix won.
This is the scene coming up that reminded me a lot of Neon Genesis Evangelion.
Oh no, nothing we did mattered. The Phoenix didn't win. The giant fiery dog wins anyway. So if we'd just lost all our health in that boss fight, would it not have mattered?
Joshua! Torgel.
Yeah, why do you say Torgel?
He's having like an out-of-body experience.
Spoilers.
Oh, sorry. You can't say everything I say, you say is spoilers. Everything you say, you don't say is spoilers. I don't like this.
Double standards.
Double standard.
Rules for thee, but not for me. They can't fire me. I am
the law.
Yeah. As many bitter commenters are quick to remind us every week, this site would fall apart without me around.
No, it's just Yahtzee and the chumps. Now it's going to be Yahtzee, Frost, and the chumps. Mr. 100K over there. New
band. We're going to follow up our Adventures Nigh song with more music tracks by Yahtzee and the chumps.
The chumps, yeah. I like to think of myself as one of the lead chumps.
There's a lot of games that we like because we can play a podcast while we're playing them, like Power Simulator. But if it's a game like this, and you put on a podcast to get through it, that's probably a stroke against the game. And for the record, I did indeed have to put on a podcast to get through a lot of this game.
Yeah, when I was futzing around with when I was clearing out side quests and stuff, I would be listening to podcasts or have something on the second screen.
Ooh, someone dropped an F-bomb.
Oh no, what's this?
This ain't your daddy's Final Fantasy. That's how you know it's gritty and serious now.
Because they said a cuss?
Yes, and people get their tits out.
Those are the big two. That's adulthood right there.
Although they never go so far as to let you see nip. Always have to artfully frame it so you don't see no milk squirters.
Jesus. I didn't expect you to say that. Like the Austin Powers scene? Where they keep holding up items that block the genitalia?
Except it's with the edges of the frame and stuff.
Oh. Haven't you done enough, Captain? Do you think we're ever going to get a AAA Austin Powers game?
And now he is gone. There was a mission in the GTA 1 expansion London 1969 where you got to drive a Union Jack patterned convertible car.
Incredible. I don't know what I was expecting as an answer to my question, but I appreciate that. Which, ironically enough, Rockstar developed a pair of Game Boy Color Austin Powers games. Rockstar was a very weird company before GTA 3 took off. Just a very strange company. Huh.
Were they still DMA design at that point?
No, by that point they were Rockstar. They were DMA design. I know like Space Station Silicon Valley, which was one of my favorite N64 games, was a DMA design game.
They were still called DMA design when they made Lemmings. Yeah, that's but right. You didn't know that. That's game right. Trivia I lovers. The developers of Grand Theft Auto were in the olden times the developers of Lemmings.
Look at that. Remember Manhunt? Did you like Manhunt?
No.
Neither did I. Did you like the Warriors? I like the Warriors.
I know a lot of people seem to like that.
Oh, no. They're just killing everyone.
And they're letting this one live for reasons.
Because they want to super punish him. By making him be a slave shoulder. Slave soldier. Man, that was weirdly hard to say. Title screen drop. Yeah.
They make him a slave soldier because he's a magic user?
Yeah. Well, and also I think his mom is very spiteful.
Yeah, as we discussed.
Yeah.
Sort of in a slightly difficult to believe kind of way.
Yeah.
Some time later, 13 years later, we actually know the specific amount this time.
It wasn't just some time.
Ooh, maybe we will get to meet Sid.
Yeah, I think in 15 minutes we will.
Sorry.
Paul Hollywood, I should say.
Let's just say Shiva and Titan's little...
Martin Torres, they killed those ladies because they couldn't have any witnesses they didn't trust to the act of treason.
Okay. Who would they worried would find out? The Duke that they just murdered?
And
it's as you thought. I just think it looked cool. John Connor,
that's the sort of question that makes the whole sentiment fall apart, doesn't it? Who were they worried would find out that this woman, who is about to become like the Emperor's wife, betrayed the kingdom?
I mean, if they started talking amongst the people and the general populace knew what she did
the general populace they're oppressing and they're absolutely powerless.
Yeah, but that could be a spark that allows the general populace to rise up. Not today. Then it's settled. John Connor, $2 Canadian. Thank you so much, John. Let's turn Devil May Cry into a tactical RPG now. Tit for tat. It's only fair.
Or Persona 5, even.
Yeah, we're getting Tactica. It's
yeah. Coming.
New icon abilities. Something that can do this. They don't.
Only the girl holding its leash. I wish Van been a member for Clive had a faster run button.
I completely agree. Holy smokes. Especially in large areas. Like, you eventually unlock a chocobo, but a lot of areas you can't have a chocobo.
Wait for me. Wait for me. I'm very slow.
Come on, Papa. I'm coming, Papa. I'm coming. Van, been a member for 19 months. Thank you so much, Van. How come post-ZP is out of sync? We changed the... wait, it's not out of sync.
Well, we changed this to sync with the public release rather than the
private
release. For the private release.
Makes more sense that way.
Because the private release has become slightly more private.
Yeah. Van, you are a member, so obviously you have access to the Dave the Diver. Zero punctuation for next week, which will go to the public next week, and that is when Yahtzee will do his post-CP on it.
Assuming I don't get another apocalyptic migraine.
Yeah. Do you think you gave it to Nick? Because Nick got one yesterday and couldn't do his Dark
Souls. Yeah, I heard about that. It certainly seems to be going around.
But there was also some rumors that he was just afraid of fighting the Pursuer again because he was having a hard time fighting the Pursuer. So there's some scuttlebutt that he's afraid.
Just use the ballista.
Did you hear that?
I'm not... Don't ask me. I'm not Nick. Wojtek. $5 donation. So, greatest war bear of all time. Appreciated all the Game of Thrones references. It's funny because some of it... At a certain point...
You probably liked this game quite a lot then.
It's funny because it feels like so much of like fantasy has become a hodgepodge. Where you're like, is this? I was watching the Dungeons and Dragons movie that came out recently. Very good movie. And so much is like, this is kind of like Game of Thrones. This is kind of like Lord of the Rings, which is all kind of like Dungeons and Dragons, which is all kind of like the original Lord of the Rings. It's all just a cosmic gumbo of fantasy.
Where did that all start? Did you want to say, like, Lord of the Rings was the first to codify that sort of thing? Or is it... Or do you want to say, like, the tradition of sort of Arthurian legend sort of setting?
Sure. Yeah, because Lord of the Rings, like, pulls from a lot of different mythologies and legends.
Yeah, it's mainly inspired by, you know, sort of Celtic mythology.
Yeah.
Sort of Northern Europeans. Like, a blend of Viking and... more sort of Arthurian. Vikings had elves. Elves show up in Viking mythology.
There you go. You go there in God of War Ragnarok. You go to Elfheim.
Yeah. You go to Elfland. Hey, that's a rapier.
Poke, poke, poke. Stick him with the pointy end.
So it's supposed to be surprised after this scene that this is Jill. Because you'd think Clive would have recognized her by now.
I mean, 13 years is a long time, and I think he assumed she was dead, probably.
Well, how many teenage girls with hair the color of an elderly lady do you know?
Two. I guess they're not teenagers. I know two people in their 20s. If that counts. 13 years is a long time. Especially if you're not expecting someone.
Biff, baff, boff. Biff, bash, boff.
Biff, baff, buff.
Blimey, what's that dress made of? I've hit it like 90 times.
Ice magic.
Hitty, 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 hit. Hitty, 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 hit. One eye on the cooldowns. Oh, ready for another one. Alright, see you next time. Oh, Blizzaga now, is it? You bitch.
No, you're about to murder her. Your future lover. I feel like that was, you can't say Shiva defeated when she's not in Shiva form.
Shiva's dominant.
Yeah. Kelly now Engineering.
Now that she's stopped moving, well, I recognize the lady.
Her. Kelly Engineering, upgrade their membership to bonus content. Thank you so much, Kelly. And Captain President with another $10 dono. This fight feels like the internet encapsulated three dudes beating up on a girl while she's down. Sounds about right.
But she's Shiva's dominant, which makes her very powerful. Wait, she's sleepwalking through the scene. Now I recognize her.
Oh, you know who's coming soon? Sidolphus.
We've got to kill a dude first. We've got to kill Sean Bean first.
We got 8 minutes. I think we'll get him.
Clive's getting fresh. What are you doing? Orgohinda Vibra! Get your ass over here and help me with these bastards! I'm sorry, Jill. I'm sorry I hit you around the head with my massive sword 50 times.
Sorry.
That's probably going to leave a scratch or two.
Apologies.
Stab, stab, stab. Stab, 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 stab. Animal Stab, stab, stabity, stab, stabity, stab, stab. Stab, 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 stab. Stab, kick. Ooh. Right in the nads.
Stab, kick. Paul with a $2 dono. Bring back the halfling Musk and Marty, I mean Buka. That was a reference to the side quest.
Musk was not halfling. Betray the Holy
Empire. Betray. Bring back best halfling Musk. I don't know.
Musk was a Paul. Changeling, wasn't she?
Was a changeling, yeah.
Halfling's a different thing.
Halfling's like a little hobbit. Are you going to be able to do it? Are you getting 6 minutes? Are we going to be able to get to Sidolphus?
Oh, I'm fairly confident.
I believe in you.
Dabbity, stabbity, stab. Stab, stab, stab. Haha, too slow, Sean Bean.
Sean Bean.
Hey, you wait there while I hit you with my huge metal sword 50 times.
Probably says the Cid fellow better be worth 2 hours. Spoilers, it probably will not be. However, Cid is a very good character. I'm a big fan of Cid in this game. Arguably best Cid in Final Fantasy history.
Oh, that's gonna be a controversial statement.
I think so. I think he's my favorite Cid.
You sucked in National Treasure, and you suck now.
Oh, no. There's a whole generation of people who fucking love National Treasure. Let me say.
Christ knows why.
You bested Tiamat.
Yeah. Damn straight he's bested. I'll best him all over the place. I'll best him a second time. I'll best all over his shorts.
What? I was kind of zoned out for a second. I was like, oh no. You're best all over his shorts?
Yeah. They call me the shorts bester. Besting makes me feel good. Yeah, I'll best all over this lady later.
Oh no, that's after another time jump.
Oh,
lightning.
All those dudes got bested all over.
They got very bested. Bested by the best Cid. Paul with a $2 dono, thank you so much. Adapted or amended best changeling Musk and good boy Toffee. Toffee's been doing great.
Straight.
Oh my god, what timing. Look at it. Look who's back. Torgal and Cid together.
I thought it was a little contrived that Torgal just happens to be here.
That's why the DLC will be. What was Torgal up to in 13 years?
Thanks for the assist, Paul Hollywood.
Well, Fungus Finder with a $2 dono. Thank you so much. Yahtzee is the master bester. Congrats,
I'm the bester beta.
Oh no.
Hugo, dear, my desert lion. We thought you had taken care when chasing the hare. I expected more from the mighty Titan. You put the Ice Queen on her back. No doubt.
Who's she talking to?
She's got a Bluetooth headset in. It's like when you pass a person on the street and you think they're crazy, but it just turns out they're on a phone conversation.
Is that what the cigarette holder's for?
It is.
Little microphone just in the end there.
It is a vape pen / microphone.
Who's doing everyone's hair off screen?
Everyone looks great.
I know.
They got great stylists in this place.
Never a thread out of place. Well, let's get a token bit more Sid before we stop.
Jill. Is it really you?
Clive's trying to best Sid in the deepest voice contest.
He is not trying to best.
And he just can't compete, and he knows it deep in his heart.
Oh, the guitar.
Saved your life, that's who.
Sid must smoke like a fucking chimney.
His name is Torgal.
You two acquainted?
Also, Sid's buddy who hangs out at the hideaway is a lot like Hodor.
Yeah, and he's got the same haircut that I keep bringing up. He just looks like a larger, fatter version of Sid.
Maybe he admires Sid. He just wants to be like Sid.
I'd heard rumors that you'd survived.
Classic Gertz.
But I never paid them much heed. Calm down. I didn't come all this way for your handsome mug. Now her, on the other hand, she seemed worth muddying my boots for. Away. Still, might be best to get a second opinion. Back her up.
I like how he's dressed like the Dread Pirate Roberts.
No. Not another step. I mean it.
Well, I'm not about to leave her here. Not when we've a warm bed waiting.
So waking up now, there's a big doggy on screen, are you?
No. Does Toffee know that the stream's over? Is that why, like, Toffee stood up?
It's like, well, it's not like the podcast, so I'm not taking him for a walk after this.
Oh.
I got some other work to do.
Non-walk-based work.
Yeah. Probably play some Remnant 2.
Ooh.
He's still debating whether you're awake or not, Toffee? He's working his way up. He's stretching, he's yawning. He's figuring it out. Okay. Well, with naps, our naps, token appearance... And back to sleep. So with the token appearance of Sid, that we've seen about as much of the game as we need.
Yay.
I'd say... Thanks for watching the post-CP stream. I hope you've learned everything you needed to know about Final Fantasy 16.
Great game. Everyone buy it. Go out and buy a PlayStation 5.
There was some intrigues. There was some asshole mums. There was some kaiju fights. And the rest of the game is basically just all of that in varying sequences.
With a sex scene later on.
Yes, yes. Well, you see them no-clothes snogging, but they don't go as far as, you know, depicting the old... In out.
You have to play New Game Plus Final Fantasy mode.
They just sort of tastefully fade out. Not that I was really, really paying attention or anything.
You were expecting full penetration.
Yeah, you can't. Toffee's gone out of shot now, but he literally just moved straight out, slightly out of shot, and then flopped down on another cushion for more sleeping, having gotten his exercise for the day in. All right. Well, what shall we plug now? Anything else coming up today?
Yeah, we'll be back in an hour. We'll have Breakout, and then so tune in for that. Nick, Casey, and I will be there 8 o'clock. I think they're going to be wrapping up Dante's Inferno. Tomorrow we got the normal streams, Gears of War Judgment at noon, and then more Half-Life 2 Episode 2 at 7 p.m. We still got David the Gnome with us. We'll be continuing to crack on through the game with that. And then tune in Friday. Big special announcement. Friday at noon, Barbie Week is commencing. Jack purchased a Barbie Three Musketeers video game for the Wii, and we're going to be streaming that at noon on Friday.
Oh, shit.
Barbie and the Three Musketeers.
I really don't know what to expect.
It's going to be great. Well, it's just like the classic Three Musketeers story, but with Barbie.
Okay. Barbie I look Week. Forward to the bit where Barbie sword duels Cardinal Richelieu and then hangs Milady from a tree.
He also bought a Barbie GBA game that I believe is Barbie as a spy. And so depending on how Barbie and the Three Musketeers go, we might pivot to also Barbie and the spy. So
I'm going to fucking watch the Barbie meets the Three Musketeers stream to see if Cardinal Richelieu shows up.
Richelieu or bust.
Anyway. Me? Well, I've got an extra punctuation dropping for members tomorrow.
Tangentially related to Final Fantasy 16.
Otherwise, that's it for me for this week. I'll be back on Monday for the usual slightly something else.
And Saturday.
What?
That's not it for you. Adventurer's Night, Saturday.
Oh, yes. Well, it's it for me for things I have to do. But on Saturday...
things April you did.
But on Saturday, something I did in April will come out.
Yeah.
The first episode of Adventurers Nigh Season 3 will be going out for members on Saturday. So remember to tune in. It's terribly important that you watch that.
It'll be a goodie. I'm excited to see how this looks. This is
Me too. I haven't seen it yet.
More premiere. Yeah.
I want to see how it all came out. I saw preview video for members and I thought my hair looked a bit weird. So we'll see how the rest of it goes.
Because you didn't see yourself in a small, like, low-definition box. You saw yourself on a nice HD camera.
I know.
Everyone looks weird in HD.
Probably.
Yeah.
All right. That's it from us. Cheery bye.
Hey, everyone. Thanks for hanging out.
Bye. I ain't talking to you, Toffee. Yeah, come back into shot very briefly. There
Toffee
he
not
is.
Going anywhere.
There he is. He's wide awake now, aren't you? Yeah. Bye, everyone.
Bye, all.